My name is Andrei Ignat. It doesn't write on the presentation board, but let me present and introduce myself as a programmer from 97 with Visual Basic 3. Visual Basic 3? So there are people that are old enough, sorry. And now I'm a technical director at Electronic Arts, and I manage a farm about more than 100 consoles, much more. So my presentation for today wants to give you a fast architecture with a backend that happens to be .NET Core, because I have been in Visual Basic, so it was the obvious evolution in .NET Core, and with Angular, because I have been chosen between Angular, React, and Vue, and we choose Angular, not React like my predecessors here. So, okay, doesn't matter if it's Angular, React, or Vue. And my purpose here is to make you understand this kind of image that is an architecture that with these two elements, with a backend, again, happens to be .NET Core, could be PHP or another framework, and the front-end framework could be Angular, Vue, React, anything. With those two, you could develop simultaneously a web, a desktop, and a mobile. Okay, so let's start with the agenda. I do not know if I could make all the agenda, but if not, we talk in the break, right? So it's okay. The people from the back could come in front because it will be some code there. So if you do not see, please come near me. Okay, so the agenda, it's about me. It's showing the .NET Core backend with business layer, data access layer, security, and test. It will be Angular that will make a website that will discuss with the backend. It will be Angular plus Electron that will be desktop. Desktop will be for Linux and from Mac. And will be Angular plus Cordova that will be mobile, again, mobile for iOS and for Android. I will present a desktop for Windows. I will present a mobile for Android. Believe me, it's the same for iOS. I didn't want to buy an iOS just to develop for iOS. So that's another problem. Okay, so this is me. This is my blog of programming. I am ASP.NET forum moderator. I have some vlog. I have been writing a book that it was lots of fun about how to copy paste from Stack Overflow. Please raise off your hand who has copied in his life from Stack Overflow. Okay, there are people that doesn't recognize this. I think so. Okay, and we have monthly meeting in Bucharest. So if you come to Bucharest, please join the meetings. Okay, so .NET Core backend, business layer, data access layer, security test. It's not a real application that I want to show you. It cannot be shown in just an hour, but I have made just real application, and at work, at EA, we do this kind of stuff in order to develop our application and to set to executive that mostly have Macs. Happens. They like Macs. Okay, so let's start with the .NET application. We have here an important class that has a divide function. The divide function waits 5 seconds, then it throws an argument exception if the second argument is zero, because dividing by zero cannot be, so I put a custom error, and then returns the divide between the two elements. So let's pretend that this is a very important business layer function that performs some machine learning or something else. Right, so, okay. What you should do in the backend? In the backend, you should do, first of all, test. This is the most important part of the backend. You should have test for the business logic that you implement. Why? Because the front end, any kind of JavaScript kiddie could make your web application irrelevant. So it's better to have test. How many tests we have to have here in this function that throws an exception and returns the divide between the two? At least two, right. So at least two. One that divides. So I have put here, I am old fashioned, so it's arrange act assert. So I have the important class here. I call the divide. And then I equal the result with the sum. And this is x unit. And we have inline data that says 15 by 5 is 3. And 10 by 2 is 5. So I have put here two tests. And we have another test. That tries to divide by 0, 15 by 0, and says record exception, and we assert that the exception that we receive, it's an argument exception that we have been throwing at the beginning. So at least two, because we have just two things to cover. Okay, let's see that it works. In the test explorer, I click run all, okay. I think that I have already compiled, but let's see that it works. And after 50 seconds, you'll see that all the tests are green, so all it's okay, perfect, it's all tested. So why I stress this kind of thing? Because first of all, before making tests on the web, on the graphical user interface, you should have test on your business layer. If your Scrum Master or your product manager doesn't give you time, my unofficial advice is to make larger the duration of the routing code in order to put the test there. So this is an official advice. I cannot advise you, but I advise to have time to make the test. Okay, how we make here the code to be seen by the graphical user interface? I made a simple .NET Web API. I have a function that says ping. The ping function, it's a simple function that says that my API, it's running. So in order to see that it's running, I have put a function that it's ping. In .NET Core 2.2, you have a health check. If you, it's not necessary to have this ping, but usually I put a ping function in order to see that it works. And here, it's again the same code that says that I have the important class. I divide the string that I receive from body. Sorry, let me show you here. I have a class that has two arguments, x and y, and I call the important class. This concept about the controllers in a web API that just calls the business function, it's called skinny controllers. So your controllers should not have any kind of logic. They should just call the business layer. Why? Because you can test much easier the business logic rather than controllers. So my advice here is to make the same thing, just call the business logic that you have presumably wrote test for them, and it's all okay. So, and when we catch the exception, we return bad request. And you see here a to-do that says log. And this is your choice how you want to do the log. And I return bad request with the message. This is battle raging. So if you are in a startup, I think that you should not return the message. But if you are in a multinational, maybe you should return in order to understand the problem faster and understand what's there. But this is another story. Okay, I think that this is pretty easily to understand. And if I run the project, and I put API. Sorry, it is API simple div. Ping, the answer is Pong, so the API works. The other does I cannot show you for the moment because it's an HTTP post. Generally, if you make some business logic, you should make a post, not a GET, because you can have some caching, but this is another story again. Okay, so until now, all is clear. We have a backend. Again, doesn't matter if it's .NET Core or PHP or whatever, with a function that it's tested and knows that performs the his function. The second thing that we should make, it's a website. So a website that calls the backend that we just constructed, we just built, and we will see now, let me compile the code. All the code is on GitHub. I will share with you the GitHub so you can reproduce if you install Angular and NPM modules and everything there. So it's the code is there. So if we put one web, it will compile. You cannot see, but let me copy this and put in a notepad and format font 36. So it will compile the Angular. What does the Angular? So the Angular, I hope that you see here, has two inputs, a first number and a second number with two inputs that will send via service. It will send back to the API. So this interface that you have seen here, basically this interface is the Angular part that has the two numbers that I want to calculate the divide between them. And if I calculate, let me refresh the page, it's deployed on Heroku, and if I calculate after 5 seconds, it will give me that 15 by 3, it will be 5. The 5 seconds I have put a timer to see the result. So this is the Angular part, and again, doesn't matter Angular, Vue, React, anything that you want, doesn't matter. So here what I have done is to compile the Angular. Compiling the Angular gives me an index.html and some JavaScript files that are usually less in gigabytes, like the NPM modules that it's, I don't know, 200 megas or something. I will compile also, let me copy here. I will compile also .NET. So this is the instruction of .NET, how compile .NET. It's, I hope that this is compiling. .NET has the opportunity now, the .NET Core has the opportunity now to compile in Linux, Windows, and Mac. So you could compile, if you, I put here a release, that it's clear that it's a release build, and we have Win10 x64 that will compile for Windows 10. And if we put minus R and some Linux variant, it will be Linux and so on. You will have the resource ID. And now, when we have build, we have a .NET Core Kestrel, that it's mean a simple web server, that it's listening to a port, it's 5000. And if we run the 5000, you will see the application. And the problem is now, how could we see the application if we put the previous port here when we start the Visual Studio? Okay, I think that I have copied already now, but how we see the Angular application in .NET Core. It's not a big deal. Let me show you the code in the bot. So the code in the bot says ng build, so we build the Angular application that gives him the index.html and the JavaScript, and we copy the result of the Angular directly to .NET Core wroot. So we put the Angular application inside the .NET Core application, and it's served for inside. So in this moment, we have the application that it's .NET Core and Angular, just one. So we made just one application web that calls .NET Core and Angular. And if we want to see how it works, here in advanced, I deleted this and I click calculate. And this in advanced, it's just for demo purposes. It shows you what API it is calling. And now it, if I put nothing here, it is calling the same API as the site, localhost 5000. If I put the Heroku application that is distributed and I put calculate, it will call, okay, you'll see that doesn't work. Maybe I should call 5001 with HTTPS because it's HTTPS Heroku. Because of course, it's not the moment to explain course, but if you call from a website, another website, you will encounter some course problems and you should allow for this. Okay, I have put too much dots there. Okay, and I call Heroku now. And doesn't work for a reason. Let me try to put a slash. I have worked last night and another two presentations that I have been, but it will work. I will see what happens. So for the moment, what we have one application that calls Heroku. What we can have also, I have here a GitHub page that doesn't allow me to run .NET Core. So we have a github.io. So this github.io is just the result of the Angular, just the index.html that it's put there, and it calls the Heroku. So now I think that it should work. And give me the result of 5, please. Okay, so it works now. And if we put, I do not know, by 5, it will give me the result of 3 after 5 seconds. What is with this demo? Think about the architecture. So you could have the same application just once and send to the client as an executable that he could run from HTTP localhost. Or you could have an application on web with the web API and Angular, or you can have multiple application, and you can have multiple application web APIs with multiple Angulars that calls each one and have a distributed architecture. How many minutes I have? Sorry? 1.5 minutes. I will show you very fast. I will tell you how to run the Angular. Let's see that the Angular works. I'll try to work the Angular and I will go to the presentation very fast. So for Electron, we have the remote Electron that will build the application in the same style and will put the Angular application inside the Electron. Electron is a framework that has a Chrome inside. It's very big, I understand that it's a problem, but for a fast development, it will be easy. And this Electron will start inside the .NET Core executable, even if it's an iOS. So I do not know if it starts already. Okay. This is the building of electron. Okay. And very fast until until it runs. If you put the Angular in Cordova, you will have a mobile application that it's compiled here in Bit, ALI, and Angular Net Core Demo Android. It's a shortcut to this one, and you could download on your phone. You pass the security, obviously, to have download, and you could have this Android or iOS application. And I have some application that I have been developed with this, and I have put on Google Store and on Windows Store and on web, all three. Again, I agree that iOS is for money, but unfortunately I don't have a startup, so that's life. So this is what I want you to have and understand very fast. So if we have the same web and development, we have Angular and .NET Core in the same thing, and for desktop with Electron, Angular, and .NET Core, the same thing. We could have also Angular that calls with calls a web API. We have Angular and Electron that call this a web API, and mobile that should call this. But for Electron, we could again deploy also the .NET Core there. So we could deploy Angular and .NET Core in the same application, run .NET Core as executable, and Angular have a self-contained application, basically. And if you will use SQLite, it will be very easy. So it's just for a proof of concept, not for a full deploy application, but after this proof of concept that you deploy very fast, you could go to native script or other native framework. So just a minute, no, this is compiling, sorry for this. And this was my presentation. All the code, it's on GitHub. So GitHub, my name Ignat Andrei, Angular Net Core Demo. This is the GitHub. You can download, you have the executable here, and the presentation, it's index.html with remark, and you do not need a PowerPoint or something else. So this is the thing now.